Für die Gesellschaft bin ich ein Versager. Und durch mein Alkoholproblem und die ganzen Straftaten will später auch mit Sicherheit niemand mehr was mit mir zu tun haben.
Erich Fromm once observed that personality is a system, meaning that it does not only consist of the sum of all the different parts, but that it also has a structure. As soon as one part of the structure is altered, this touches upon all of the other parts as well. However, the structure has an inner cohesiveness that helps perpetuating itself. Since the structure shows this tendency, it also tends to neglect all attempts of change. The Blue Cross Germany is a self-help organization. It consists of more than 1,000 groups and more than 70 institutions, such as counseling centers and offices for addiction, clinics, complementary facilities, and meeting centers. The Blue Cross understands itself as a community of solidarity for people with addictions and their relatives, as an abstinence association, as value and motivation oriented with a Christian background. The history of the local department in Potsdam began as a one-man business in 1979 in the Schopenhauer Straße in Potsdam. In the prison in Brandenburg an der Havel, prisoners with addiction problems have been offered help since 1990. There, the Blue Cross is represented by Jürgen Schönagel. 1994, the range of facilities was extended by one living group named Suchtfrei Leben, and an additional one has been existing in the prison of Luckau-Dum since 2006. This treatment program in prisons is unique in Germany and is accompanied by longtime chief physician Dr. Klaus Herbert Richter of the Clinic for Addiction, Ebbingerode. In the prisons, two monolithic blocks are facing each other. On the one side, there's the panel system, on the other, the prisoners. As honorary helpers, we are caught in the middle, since there's a very clear demarcation between the blocks. Gaining trust of all protagonists involved is not easy and involves hard work. The Enforcement Act demands social rehabilitation from the first day of imprisonment. Regarding this, we have to know, when supporting prisoners, we always deal with victims. On the one hand, victims who become offenders, and on the other hand, the victims of these offenders. Because of these victims, it is essential that people who have committed a criminal offense are socially rehabilitated. The concept of social rehabilitation is based on the assumption that a human being is socialized on the basis of thought and feeling patterns shared in a society. In the reality of prisons, this means we often deal with people who have not been socialized in this way and based on these patterns.
Ja, ich bin in einer kaputten Familie aufgewachsen, habe viel eingesteckt, habe dafür auch Fälle ausgeteilt, habe Drogen genommen.
Every person has a past, especially those people who get into jail. They have a past in which they build a strong defense around themselves. If their past was not only marked by experiences from their childhood and adolescence, but also by heavy use of drugs, then they had to build this strong defense in order to survive. They learned to ignore feedback correcting their behavior and thus could not be reached. They only take note of pleasant feedback which nurtures their own doctrines. We know that once their lifestyle causes them more pain than joy, only then they will let down the wall of defense.
Ja, und jetzt ist mir klar geworden, dass ich zerstört war, kaputt war, habe nach Nähe und Liebe gesucht.
In this person we see the significance of his drug abuse and the consequences resulting from it. We see the results and we have prejudices against him respectively. We feel his defense and thereby feel how powerless we are. Like an iceberg where only 1/8 is visible, with the prisoner we also only see the part rising to the surface. This can be aggression, wrath, all these things that can cause problems for him in prison as well. This should and has to be corrected. Social rehabilitation at the example of the living group. It is of importance to know for everyone involved that all the members of the living group are participating voluntarily. The prisoners will approach the head of the program. They wish to work on their addiction because their level of suffering has become very high. In a first talk, they bring in their expectations. These expectations often only concern the consumption of drugs and the problems resulting from it. However, a change of the whole personality is necessary to overcome the drug addiction and/or the abuse of drugs. While every human being is unique, a systematization is nonetheless possible. We can see this in the model of Wilhelm Feuerlein. At the macro level, there are three units: the human being, his environment, and the drug. Without this context, the personality of the prisoner cannot be understood. The micro level specifies the units. The spiritual features are an addition to our personality, as we had to find many times in the past. It is exactly this part of the personality that people on the one hand often neglect, but on the other hand search for. In his incompleteness, the human being creates his own God. He needs his own rituals, his own doctrines, and so forth, unto which he holds tightly and without which he cannot live. Therefore, every change in his life will cause some suffering, and he will fight against a change in his personality and respectively his addictive behavior.
Tja, in die Wohngruppe Sucht frei leben zu kommen, war bei mir ein längerer Prozess. Im Basisvollzug habe ich mich halt mit meinem Alkoholismus beschäftigt und musste feststellen, dass es nicht nur Missbrauch ist, sondern dass ich eben ein klares Suchtverhalten habe und dass dadurch eben, gerade durch die Sucht, eben Gewalttätigkeiten in mir ausgebrochen sind, zum Teil Verhalten anderen gegenüber, was kränkend war, bis hin zum asozialen Verhalten.
Even the pain deriving from being imprisoned is endured heroically, as there are fellow sufferers who, like himself, evade every question concerning the meaning of life. And anyhow, who wants to admit to themselves that they have problems which they cannot handle themselves? But suddenly and unexpectedly, there is a person outside the door and wants to do something now. Our task? Socialize people who have not been socialized. This is where the hard work towards change starts. The people seeking help will be surprised again and again in which ways and in which aspects of their life they have to change. They did not even want to go this far. They just wanted to stop drinking. For them, it really is hard work. After all, their whole life is on trial and all that in a certain time given.
Für jeden Einzelnen ist es erstmal schwer zu verstehen, dass wir Maßnahmen machen müssen, uns daran auch beteiligen, mitzumachen, um uns besser kennenzulernen, um uns auch besser zu verstehen, warum wir Straftaten begangen haben, warum wir Suchtmittel zu uns nehmen und deshalb auch einen schweren Weg meistens vor uns haben.
Basic course, addiction. In order to have a common language, the persons seeking help are obliged to attend a basic course.
Weil uns ja da auch schon viel mitgegeben wird. Es ist keine Maßnahme, wo wir viel mitquatschen müssen. Es wird uns ja mehr Informationen mitgegeben. Aber wo wir dann doch meist dann als Klingengrüppchen so mal zusammensitzen und dann schon sagen, ey du, das passt irgendwie bei mir. Das Gleiche habe ich auch irgendwie so erlebt und haut schon irgendwie hin. Daher kommt ja dann, entsteht ja auch meistens die Auseinandersetzung dann untereinander schon.
This basic course is an information event with discussion elements regarding the topic addiction, from the beginning to abstinence. The course is divided in three categories with respective topics. The first category includes the personality and deals, among other things, with genetical factors, conditioning, approaches to life, as well as personality structures according to Riemann. The second category covers the addiction and addresses issues such as types of addiction, the phases of addiction, the work How Do I Become Addicted by Dr. Lindenmeyer, the course of the disease within the family, grown-up children of addicted people, as well as the issue of relapse. The third category addresses the subject of group dynamics, topics such as speaking and hearing, conflict management and active factors in the group are conveyed in this category. The task of the basic course is, through gaining knowledge, the participants are supposed to be enabled to decide on their own whether they have issues with drugs and thus can take the respective measures. In order to become a member of the living group, the persons have to file an application to the manager of the living group and have to successfully complete a 3-month trial period that can be extended if necessary.
Damals wurde ich von der Blaukreuzgruppe freundlich empfangen. Das war wie eine Familie gewesen, was ich nicht aus dem Knast so kannte. Es waren keine hinterlistigen Sachen oder Planungen gewesen, wie man Leute abzieht, was mich auch sehr gefreut hat.
Introduction of the Living Groups. Up to 15 prisoners are given the chance to work on their change of personality within a period of round about 2 years.
Die Wohngruppe hat mir geholfen, weil man hier über Probleme reden kann mit anderen, was man im normalen Strafvollzug nicht machen kann. Da es da meist zu körperlichen Auseinandersetzungen kommt.
What is unique about this group is that the Blue Cross is responsible for the content and provides the head of the program. The prison is responsible for order and security. The living group has a treatment team consisting of the head of treatment, a prison guard, the social service and a psychological service.
Der Wohngruppenalltag ist generell der Gefängnisstruktur untergeordnet. Das fängt schon morgens an von den Aufschlusszeiten her. Die Leute gehen in die verschiedensten Arbeitsbereiche arbeiten, was ganz klar vom Vollzug her geregelt wird. Eine Besonderheit ist, dass wir hier auf der Wohngruppe von morgens bis abends die Türen offen haben, was nicht üblich ist im normalen Basisvollzug. Und diese Zeit über gilt es halt natürlich selbst von uns auszufüllen mit Veranstaltungen, die wir selbst organisieren und managen, was im Basisvollzug halt nicht der Fall ist.
The living group is divided into 2 small groups. The small groups are supported by the Blue Cross addiction helpers from the local department in Potsdam. Especially the honorary helpers give the members of the living group the confidence they need to open up themselves. This is a basis of trust that often cannot be built up with prison guards.
Die Behandlung hier geschieht halt auf freiwilliger Basis. Das setzt eine gewisse Eigenmotivation heraus, sein Leben mal zu verändern. Über seine Straftaten zu reden und über seine Suchtproblematik. Die Leute, die uns helfen, die machen das halt genauso auf freiwilliger Basis. Und deshalb werden die auch mit gewissen Respekt behandelt. Und man merkt das halt gleich, dass man da halt nicht mit irgendeinem Psychologen redet, der das halt aus irgendwelchen Büchern kennt, sondern wirklich mit Menschen, die das halt selber so erfahren haben.
Through this foundation of trust, it is possible to work specifically and individually on developing the personality. Furthermore, the members help each other. Especially the personal differences among the members lead to more tolerance and openness in the individual person.
Also ich fühle mich in der Gruppe gut aufgehoben, weil es einfach gut ist zu wissen, dass man nur mit Leuten zusammen ist, die dasselbe wollen wie du. Man will sich verändern und man kriegt mit gezielten Fragen einfach hin, dass man selber darüber nachdenken muss, was in einem passiert, wie es in einem vorgeht. Und zu wissen, dass man mit Leuten zusammensitzt, die dasselbe Problem haben, tut einfach gut.
The living group is built up according to the principle of self-help, meaning the members learn to accept help and help others.
Hier in der Wohngruppe, wenn man einen Fehler macht, wird man darauf hingewiesen, was halt im normalen Strafvollzug nicht der Fall ist.
The living group is a secure space in which prisoners are given the opportunity to begin their change according to the motto, change through a change of your mind. At the beginning, every member of the living group receives a personal folder which they keep until they leave the group. With the aid of this folder, everybody, including the specialized service staff, can see the status quo of each member throughout their stay in the group. The content of the folder includes the topic of the basic course, personal artifacts, as well as monthly topics. Personal artifacts mean each member of the living group does an inventory of their past life. It starts with a crisis plan in which the members document their type of drug, the duration of their addiction, and the beginning of abstinence. The members are to name their strengths and weaknesses. Respectively, tasks will be deducted on the basis of the weaknesses named. The tasks are divided in short-term, medium-term, and long-term tasks. The time frame is the length of the stay in the group. In order to better understand their own life and their character, the members are to document the history of their addiction in the record of addiction. Aids to the inventory, such as the crisis plan, record of addiction, character and leisure time schedule, belong to the first phase of the process. Lifting the spirits is one of the members' daily duties of self-control.
Hauptsächlich ist die Pflicht auch hier in der Gruppe, dass wir miteinander auch zusammenarbeiten, dass wir auch unsere eigene Motivation auch hier mit drin bringen, also uns auch motivieren lassen und versuchen, andere auch ein Stück weit zu motivieren. Ich meine, wir als Gruppe müssen ein bisschen was auf die Beine stellen, um auch weiterzukommen. Wenn hier jeder für sich bleiben würde, wäre keine Gruppe und wir würden auch gar nichts gestalten, würden nicht die Erfahrung machen, was das heißt, als Gruppe zusammen zu arbeiten, zu bewirken, also was zu bewirken, dass wir auch viel mehr zusammenfinden, weil neue Strukturen sind, die wir auch mit der Zeit noch erlernen und uns auch helfen werden, draußen viel besser klarzukommen, weil es uns einfacher fällt, auf Menschen zuzugehen, über Probleme zu sprechen, Hilfe anzunehmen und auch zu schauen, wie viele Möglichkeiten es gibt, irgendwas zu bewältigen.
Respective to the personal development of the members, the rough topics concerning the personal roots will be brought up. We work on the often problematic past of the members. At this point, very often tears are shed as images of their childhood come alive again. Coming to terms with the past regarding the criminal offense is another part of the program. The topic of the criminal offense is only addressed in one-on-one conversations. Every member of the group has to talk about their criminal offenses with the treatment head as a preparation for the work with the psychological service.
Hier auf der Gruppe ist es natürlich auch vorteilhaft, dass wir einen Betreuer haben, wo wir regelmäßig hingehen können, um auch Probleme zu besprechen, Rat zu holen und vielleicht auch mal neue Aufgaben holen können, mit denen wir uns beschäftigen können. Und bis jetzt, also aus meiner Sicht her, waren die Aufgaben und die Hilfeleistungen, die ich von dort gekriegt habe, immer gut gewesen und haben mir bis jetzt auch immer weitergeholfen.
The worksheets are freely accessible to authorized persons at any time. In the one-on-one conversations, the folders are being updated regularly. Every week, a meeting of the big group takes place in which organizational matters are being discussed and the monthly topics are introduced. Monthly topics are, for example, access to one's own feelings, living with limits, or the meaning of life. Small group meetings take place weekly and address the monthly topics. Every meeting starts with a flashlight, after which every member gives the others insight into his interior life. Talks on various topics are a monthly highlight. The referees, such as teachers, professors of computer science, professors of theology, physicians, and even politicians, take some of their time for the members in order to help them in their situation and distract them a little.
Weil es für viele nicht einfach ist, die keine Familien haben oder keine Freunde und auch nicht wissen, wie sie neue Kontakte herstellen könnten und das dann meistens doch hilfreich ist. Wir haben auch so Veranstaltungen, wo wir Leute aus politischen Kreisen kennenlernen. Aber sind das für uns auch neue Erfahrungen? Ich meine, früher hat uns auch nie interessiert, was passiert eigentlich so in vielen Richtungen, ob das Politik ist oder in sonst welchen Bereichen. Und für uns ist es dann doch ein Stück weit hilfreich. Wir lernen so viel Neues und lernen auch damit, dass es gar nicht mal so langweilig sein muss und langweilig ist. Und daher auch, dass uns unbewusst irgendwo doch weiter mitgegeben wird, dass wir neue Strukturen eigentlich erlernen.
Additionally, the members always have the possibility and sometimes even the obligation, if there is a respective diagnosis, to make use of all treatments offered by the prison. However, there the topics often collide with the actual environment in the prison.
Ich meine, auf der einen Seite sollte zwar eine Pflicht sein, uns mit Maßnahmen auch auseinanderzusetzen, damit wir viel besser verstehen, dass wir auch ein Leben ohne Straftaten führen können und auch ohne Suchtmittel. Aber oftmals ist es so, dass wir die Maßnahmen durchlaufen, um selbst irgendwas schnell zu erreichen. Aber viele verstehen nicht, dass wir durch die Auseinandersetzung oder durch das Teilnehmen an der Maßnahme uns irgendwie unbewusst auch schon damit auseinandersetzen und meist dann auch dadurch auch verändern. Oftmals ist es aber, dass das erst in der Gruppe erst so wirklich offensichtlich auch geschieht.
Meeting with the relatives. As relatives of the living group members often have a great knowledge deficit regarding the addiction as well as the situation in the prison, the treatment includes quarterly meetings with relatives or other social contact persons. It is the aim of these meetings to stabilize and respectively reinstall social contact. Offenders often like to push away the thought that they produced victims. Depending on the nature of the offense, the degree of guilt is relativized. Scarcely any of the offenders think about the fact that their imprisonment alone has made their relatives victims. Wives, mothers, or children who have been let down? There is a lot to be processed here. The meeting with the relatives takes place in the rooms of the living group. This requires a great degree of trust on the part of the prison. Every member can receive up to 2 visitors and will find a table prepared for them and their visitors. Before relatives and members can exchange personal matters, a talk is given on a topic that has recently been discussed in the group. In the conversation with their relatives, the members are obliged to talk about the content of their folders. On this occasion, some of the relatives have to face some rather major surprises. Many of the records concerning the past gives insight into the thoughts and emotions of the group members before and during the stay in the group. Most of the time, relatives learn about things they either did not know or did not want to perceive. This is the base for processing the past together and finding a new path. We shared the opinion that a personal change and social rehabilitation can only be realized within a family context. Release, and now? The release puts the former prisoner into a mostly unfamiliar situation. A new environment, the responsibility to provide for oneself, and to live alone in a new apartment for the first time in a very long time. The Blue Cross offers participation in group meetings and church services to support the former prisoners in this situation. This way, the released prisoners are able to keep their known reference points and attachment figures. It builds an important framework for re-entering into society. There is also the possibility of working together with other organizations offering aftercare. In practice, this looks like that. Aftercare institutions will get in touch upon request by the prisoners or the social service. The prisoners may tell them which offers they made use of. However, the institution still might know nothing about the content and the prisoner's development. At this point, it is essential to have a closer look at things. There are 18 measures offered by the social services, among others offered by the psychological service. The question arising here is, who in the prison knows about the content of the measures in detail? Many times it is not quite clear whether the offers of the aftercare institutions are compatible with the things the prisoners have learned in prison. Disappointments occur repeatedly on both sides when an integration has failed. Even though the organizations introduce their programs to the prisoners, irritations are inevitable. The prisoners just want to be released and would promise anything to achieve this goal. The relapse rate is too high, though. Summary. For successful social rehabilitation, the following aspects have to be observed. The voluntary will of the prisoner to change is indispensable. A forced change will automatically lead to lies, disguises, and so on. What can be concluded from that? It is essential that the psychological strain does not only arise from the imprisonment. Education and training are an integral part of the formation of the personality. This results in spatial separation from prisoners who are not willing to change, emphasizing advantages of the treatment. Training of prison guards. Continuing further training of prison guards. Acquisition of honorary helpers. A shared conception and trust between honorary helpers and the prison. And permanent supervision. Social rehabilitation in reality is more than a working off of measures. It would not work without human care.
Im Einzelgespräch mit den Wohngruppenmitgliedern erlebe ich Folgendes. Es geht sehr in die Tiefe, auch in die Niederlagen des eigenen Lebens. Und in der Erkenntnis daraus fließen oft Tränen. Wenn das Gespräch zu Ende ist und er wieder aus meinem Zimmer rausgeht, dann schüttelt er sich kurz und übernimmt sofort die Rituale, die so im Gefängnis üblich sind. Daraus wird mir klar, dass wir uns sowohl als Ehrenamtler als auch die Kollegen vom Vollzug nicht vorstellen können, welchen Mut ein Mensch im Gefängnis aufbringen muss, um zu signalisieren, ich ändere mich. Deshalb halte ich diese Art der Behandlung für die optimale Form. Über den Leidensdruck in Haftierung resultierend aus seinem Suchtmittelmissbrauch haben wir die Möglichkeit, ihn zur Sinnfindung seines Lebens zu führen.